Rogue liberal judge just ruled taxpayers must fund transgender sex reassignment surgeries, blocks ban. Transgender issues seem to be an important talking point for liberals, especially in recent years. But as each year passes, something even more absurd passes or happens with regard to the issue. Just this past Tuesday, a federal district court judge ruled in Maryland that taxpayers in the United States will continue to pay for transgender reassignment surgeries after they served in the military. In the decision, the judge noted he passed it because transgender individuals have already suffered enough under President Trump. American Military News wrote, "The Trump administration can't deny funding for certain medical care for transgender service members," said District Judge Marvin Garbus, The Washington Post reported. In his 53-page order, Garbus said the transgender service members challenging the ban have demonstrated that they are already suffering harmful consequences such as the cancellation and postponements of surgeries, the stigma of being set apart as inherently unfit, facing the prospect of discharge and inability to commission as an officer, the inability to move forward with long-term medical plans, and the threat to their prospects of obtaining long-term assignments, the Post reported. In October, another U.S. District Court judge ruled that there can be no changes to the U.S. military's transgender policy while there is a pending case against the proposed ban that is being reviewed in court. That judge, Colleen Collar Cote, had denied a motion to block the ban on gender reassignment funds. President Donald Trump in August signed a directive that instructed the Pentagon to prohibit transgender people from joining the military, and it gave Defense Secretary Jim Mattis the power to remove any transgender service member based on deployability. The new directive was also to end payments for gender reassignment surgeries for those in the military, as well as other medical treatments for gender transitioning. Collar Cote had held that the plaintiffs have established that they will be injured by these directives, due both to the inherent inequality they impose, and the risk of discharge and denial of accession that they engender, CNN reported. The U.S. government had argued that the lawsuit was premature, CNN reported, and to dismiss the case. On July 26, Trump announced the ban in three tweets that seemingly blindsided officials and outraged many people. "After consultation with my generals and military experts, please be advised that the United States government will not accept or allow transgender individuals to serve in any capacity in the U.S. military," Trump had tweeted. "Our military must be focused on decisive and overwhelming victory and cannot be burdened with the tremendous medical costs and disruption that transgender in the military would entail," he said. Mattis reportedly had 6 months from August, which would put the end date sometime in or around February, to prepare to implement the White House's directive. After the president's directive was released, Mattis in August said that transgender troops will continue to serve in the U.S. military, pending the results of a study from experts Mattis will select who will provide advice on Trump's recent memorandum. The American Civil Liberties Union, ACLU, in August announced it was suing President Trump over his transgender ban for the U.S. military. The New York Times wrote, "The suit was filed by GLBTQ legal advocates and defenders in the National Center for Lesbian Rights on behalf of five unnamed transgender women serving in the Coast Guard, Army, and Air Force. Many of the women had served for years as men and had been deployed to war zones before coming out to commanders when the ban was lifted in 2016. One is a few years from retirement, according to court documents. Another told her commander she wanted to keep serving, but would resign if the military moved to forcibly discharge her." "Big, huge news today," said Lieutenant Commander Blake Drimmon, a Navy Supply Corps officer who is transgender and is the director of SPARTA, an LGBT military group with more than 650 active duty members. "A lot of people's lives were put on hold. They thought their careers were ending. This means we can continue to serve with honor, as we have been doing." Petty Officer Eva Carey, 24, who is transgender and is training to operate nuclear reactors, said the ruling lifted an obsessive dread over the impending end of a Navy career she loves. "I remain optimistic that the Constitution I swore an oath to will continue to protect the rights of all Americans," she said on Monday. The decision is the latest in a series of controversial White House policies halted by the courts, including limiting travel from predominantly Muslim countries and withholding federal grant money from so-called sanctuary cities. Asked for comment, Sarah Huckabee Sanders, the White House press secretary, said the Justice Department was reviewing the ruling. The lawsuit is premature, the Justice Department said, because none of the plaintiffs have established that they will be impacted by current policies on military service. The decision is a blow for social conservatives, who have pushed to curtail transgender policies since the ban was lifted in 2016. In June, some Republicans in Congress unsuccessfully sought to force a ban on sex reassignment surgery by attaching it to the annual military spending bill. In response, Mr. Trump made a far bolder move to ban transgender service members entirely. This issue has stayed out of the media for the most part for a while now. But it resurfaces every once in a while. Issues like these arise in the media when Republicans are doing well pushing the agenda promised in 2016. And liberals want to try and take away from this achievement and recognition. Considering the House of Representatives just passed tax reform, it fits perfectly within this timeline. Considering all of the serious issues the White House and the administration are currently dealing with, it seems like a ridiculous issue for the media to be perpetually reporting on. Yet it always remains at the forefront of all the mainstream media news outlets.